Let's see what happened in the year without a Santa Claus. Can you stop? Thanks, Gross. The year without a Santa Claus. Have you ever been told, did you ever hear of the curious, furious, fidgety year when Santa Claus unhitched his sleigh and vowed he was taking a holiday? How did it happen?
Christmas canceled.
This way. It was long ago before you were living. Not yes Christmas, but past Thanksgiving. Though I cannot give you the exact date. Long, long ago this happened.
Thousand years ago?
No, in the past.
In the past. Very good. Santa got up that morning late. He pulled on one boot and then its twin. He ruffled the whiskers on his
beard
and sat back down on the side of the bed. Oh, great Northern Star, I'm so tired, he said. Painting wagons red and bright, sharpening ice skates half the night, wrapping presents in ribbons and gauze has worn me weary, said Santa Claus. Crick in my back and a cold in my nose, aches in my fingers and all 10 of my toes, and sort of a kink inside whenever I think I'm at that Christmas ride.
Ooh. That all rhymes.
Yeah, I think he's probably worn out.
He is worn out, very worn out. Into his workroom limped the saint. He sniffed the varnish and he smelled the paint. And a reeling feeling came over him stealing to see things crammed from the floor to the ceiling. Rocking horses with shaggy manes, balls and dolls and electric trains, gloves and mitts and doctor's kits, rubber boots and cowboy suits, kites for flying in the parks, bicycles and Noah's Ark. And he started to shake and he started to shiver at the thought of the load that he must soon deliver.
That's a big load. Too big.
I bet he goes higher and higher.
Well, it goes higher until the roof is built.
What?
Well,
there's thousands of kids in the
world. Oh dear! As he buttoned his vest, I wish one year I could just take a rest. When the words were out, he stood stock still, and then he whispered, I think I will. I will, he cried with his eyes ablaze. Everyone gets holidays. Sailors and tailors and cooks do. Policemen and writers of books do. Tamers of lions and leopards, and preachers and teachers, and shepherds, and watchmen and Scotchmen, Spaniards and Turks, butchers and bakers and grocery clerks. They take time off as Christmas nears, all except me, or so it appears. Stop.
Jones?
So it appears that saint or not, it's time I got my first vacation in 1,000 years.
He probably can do it not on Christmas. He probably can do it on other holidays.
So he should take a break on another holiday, right? Just not Christmas. Well, yeah. Out in the stable, nuzzling hay, the reindeers dreamed of Christmas Day. But Santa phoned to the reindeer groom. Hang up the harnesses in the big store room. He called to his elves and he told each gnome, cover up the shelves, we're staying home. What? Cover the shelves? Cried the gnomes and the elves. Cover the dolls and the electric chains and the rocking horses with the shaggy manes and the rubber boots for splashing in parks and the cowboy suits and the Noah's Arks? Alas, alack, for they couldn't believe they wouldn't be riding on Christmas Eve. Oh no is right. Oh my word. Put them away, roared Santa, he vexed. This year's presents will just do for next. Warn the people, tell the papers, I'm much too tired for any Christmas capers. Crick in my back, cold that lingers.
lingers, aches in my toes and all 10 of my fingers. Bit of a lumbago, a touch of gout. Climbing down chimneys is simply out. I might be the saint of the children's nation, but this year, my friends, is my first vacation.
It cannot be your very first. You have.
Well, you can imagine that more or less what happened when the news reached the press. Headlines screamed and wires went humming. Santa says he's too tired. He's not coming. And as the word flashed far and wide, you should have heard how the children cried. Can all you guys cry? So violently they sobbed. Their griefs in the shops ran out with their handkerchiefs. Their tears filled up the kitchen sinks and cellars and empty skating rinks. They wept in school, at play they wept. They dampened their pillows while they slept. Before those darlings' eyes got drier, all the rivers rose 3 feet higher. And I don't know what would have happened next, quite except for Ignatius Thistle.
Up in a court.
Well, Ignatius Thicklewhite was a boy in Texas, or possibly Illinois. 6 years old, but brave for his years. He sobbed no tears, and he wept no tears. Sorry, but stood up tall in class to say, Santa deserves a holiday. Sorry. No, 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 came the children's plaint. What is Christmas without our saint? Oh, shucks now, fellows, gosh, good gracious, Christmas is Christmas, cried Ignatius. And everyone tells me, whom I've met, it's a day to give as well as get. Since all these years in the children's cause, Santa's been giving without one single pause. Let's pull together in this Christmas weather and give this year to Santa Claus. Hooray, his classmates said, he's right. 3 cheers for Ignatius Thistlewhite. Can you guys say that? Ignatius Thistlewhite. Ignatius, stop. You can try. Ignatius Thicklewhite. Ooh, what a name.
Ms. Jones.
Well, fast as a hurricane, the children hurl that happy message. I got a cough going. Fast as a hurricane, the children hurled that happy message around the world. Over the continents, isles, and isthmus, let's give Santa a Merry Christmas. With snow, the earth was already whitening, but they rolled up their sleeves and worked like lightning. They opened their piggybacks, they racked their brains, they chartered buses and special trains, and ships and sledges and hydroplanes to reach the pole by the 24th was their goal. Why do they want to reach it by the 24th? What happens on the 24th?
Christmas Eve.
Christmas Eve. Very good. So they're trying.
One bowl.
Sorry. East and south and west and north came gifts and gifts and gifts to spare from clever children everywhere. Slippers with zippers to zip on.
Soap
for his bath or to slip on. Geraniums pink in a pot. One guppy, a puppy named Spot. Boston pillows, strawberry dram, dressing grounds with his monogram. 10 harmonicas for him to play on, hand-painted pictures done in crayon, mufflers, pipes, an easy chair, and a lot of winter underwear.
Winter underwear.
In New York State, a boy named Pudge called him a plate of homemade fudge. And a little girl out of Britain each made him a scarlet mitten, while a boy in Siam sent a Siamese kitten. They sent him lemon drops by the carton, ashtrays modeled in kindergarten, jackknives, pen wipers, cakes, and crullers, and magic pencils that wrote in 3 colors. Tots, who hadn't a penny to spend, wrote him a letter and signed it, a friend. And they had more fun that strange December, they said, than any other that they could ever remember.
Or any magic.
Up in the pole in the fragrant hay, the idle reindeer dreamed of play. Comet nickered for oats and corn, and Dancer brandished his velvet horn. While sadly and sorrowly lounged at home, each idle elf and each idle gnome, Santa sat poking at the fire and blinking, but nobody knew. What was Santa thinking?
About Christmas.
Was he thinking about Christmas, do you think?
Yeah.
Was he thinking about Christmas? Mm-hmm. I wonder, let's see. Well, suddenly from the sky, there came the sound of planes. He heard the hoot and the cry of ships and special trains. Noel told the ledges, honk, the buses cried. And out of his study window, Santa put his head. He looked left, he looked right. He didn't trust his own eyesight. So many, so merry, so more and more packages were all rolling to his front door. Smack at his door still they thundered, a million, a thousand, a hundred. Flat ones and fat ones and lean ones, crimson and silver and green ones, broad ones and odd ones and plain ones and romantic ones, little and big and great, gigantic ones. Parcels from London and Roman and Atlanta, each were addressed and they all said to Santa.
He must be.
Can you even imagine if we all sent a gift to Santa instead of Santa bringing a gift to us?
Yeah.
Atop of them all, a banner that glinted where Ignatius Thistlewhite had printed these words. Good luck and holiday mirth from all the children on the earth. Well, with toots and hoots and honks lighthearted, the buses they turned and the trains they departed, leaving the saints surrounded by parcels piled to the polar sky. Santa was silent for just a minute. His eyes, excuse me, someone's reading a book and I think it's me. Santa was silent, for just a minute. His eyes looked bright, but a tear stood in it. Then he blew his nose like a trumpet blast. Oh, God bless my soul, he said at last. By the big gorillas, by my maps and charts, I didn't know children had such kind hearts. How could a man feel gladder or prouder? Was Santa happy or sad?
Happy.
Santa was so happy.
He
turned to his staff and his voice got louder. Gnomes and elves and every mother's son, don't stand there staring. There's work to be done. Bring in the barrels, fetch all the boxes, carry in those package, and don't break one. Oh, where to put them? There wasn't any space in his parlor or study or any old place. They overflowed bureau and couch and a table. They filled the whole house, the sheds, and the stable. They slid from the mantels, they jammed from the casement, bulged from the attic, and they burst from his basement. There's nothing to do, exclaimed the elves, except to empty some workshop shelves.
Oh no!
Okay, guys.
Off those shelves, then Santa's forces whisked the painted rocking horses. When the presents wouldn't fit, down came a kite and a doctor's kit. Still, there wasn't room for all, so away went basketball, cowboy suit, rubber boot, bicycle, and talking doll. Till by the time the twilight reigned, Cooper. All were stacked and packed away. In one place left was the Christmas sleigh. And then Santa gazed from floor to rafter, and he gave his mightiest shout of laughter. Laugh, laugh, ho, ho, ho's, and ha, ha, ha's. What a joke from Santa Claus. Well, you might as well phone the reindeer's groom to take down the harnesses in the big storeroom. Get me my gloves, the rope for my lap, and my coat, and my warmest stocking cap. There's the sleigh.